Hello, Internet, and welcome back to the Data Science community. And today's the day. Today's the day where we finally get to build our machine learning model. Today, I'll be teaching how to pick your response class, your target variable. I'll be teaching how to split and partition your data so you can have withhold data. And then I'll teach you how to pick a model, train your model, score your model, and then evaluate your model. So the first thing we have to do is we have to tell Azure ML what it's looking for. What is it trying to predict? And that's going to be our response class. So we're trying to tell Azure ML that we want it to predict survived based upon these predictor variables. To do that, we actually have to cast survived into a label as well as a categorical, which it already is. So it will be simultaneously categorical and a label class. If you guys remember from our previous video, we used metadata editor module to cast our columns. So I'm just going to copy and paste one of the metadata editors I have up here, and then I'll just reroute it to our continued workflow data set. And then I'm going to launch the column selector, and we're trying to classify just survived as a label. So I'm just going to cross all those out, and I'm just going to leave the categorical unchanged because it's already categorical. And then I'm just going to change the fields into a label. So now that will correctly mark it as a label. And I'll run my model. Now that that is done, let's go and visualize our data to see what happened to survive. So as you can see, survive got properly cast into both a categorical and a label. The next thing we're going to do is actually partition our data. And that can be done under data transformation and sample and split. And you will find a split module. The split module will take in a dataset input, partition the dataset into two parts, and return one part in the left output node and the other in the right output node. You can specify how much you want to split via this fraction box right here. Whatever decimal that you put in this box will actually output to the left output node. The remainder of the data will actually go to the right output node. For example, if you wanted a 70-30 split between your training data and your validation data, you would just put a 0.7 right here, and it would output 70% of your data to the left node and 30% of your data to the right node. And then yes, you do want to randomize that split. Some of you watching this video are probably more used to a framework that uses three partitions rather than two partitions. So instead of just a training and a validation set, you also have a third testing set. So let's say you wanted a 60-30-10 partition between your score, your validation, and your testing module. So you will need two split modules to accomplish this. So we'll make this node right here the test node. This will be the validation node, and this will be the scoring node. Since we know that we want 10% in the test node, that means that the remaining split on the left node has to be 90%. So let's plug that in to the parameter. So we want 90% of our data going into the left side. We wanted our score node to have 60% of the data, and we want our validation node to have 30% of the data. We'll just need to do a little bit of math to figure out what 60% of 90% is, and that's about 2/3. So let's just put that into the left node as 0.66667. And that's how you achieve a three-way partition in your data sets. However, I'm going to continue forward with the two-way split validation. Now that that's done running, let's just check up on our validation set and see what's there. So if you remember, we have a 30% withhold on our data set for validation. So that equates to 267 rows. And that concludes how to split and partition your data. The next thing we need to figure out is what kind of machine learning model are we going to apply to our data? So we can tell what kind of model we actually want to use from what kind of data that we have. Whatever model we choose from has to be able to spit out categorical values as its output. So that tells us that it's a classification problem, but it also has to spit out binary categorical values. So that tells us that it's a two-class classification problem. And then whatever model we choose from has to also be able to take in nominal and ordinal categorical data, as well as numerical data. All the machine learning models in Azure ML at your disposal is under a drop-down menu called Machine Learning. Just click on that, and then in that, you click on Initialize Model. And this is where all your models are kept, and they're classified by what kind of machine learning problem you're dealing with. So since earlier I said we were probably dealing with a classification problem, let's click on Classification. You can also see that it is sorted by what kind of classification model it is. So earlier we established that what we're dealing with is probably a two-class classification model. Because of the nature of the Titanic data being both ordinal, nominal, categorical, and numerical, it basically lends itself to a decision tree. But let's go one step further and do a decision forest. Let's have a forest of decision trees. So go ahead and drag in the model. You can specify the parameter of any machine learning module by simply clicking on it. And with this example, we're just gonna go with the default settings. So once you have a nice, neat model picked out, you still have to train, score, and evaluate the model. And luckily, each of those modules are called exactly what they are. So drag in a score module, drag in a train module, and grab an evaluate model. So we want to train our model. The combination of algorithm and data will train your model. And we want to feed it the training set data. And then you want to take the output of the training data and bring it into the score module and bring in the validation data into the score model as well. And then finally, we want to evaluate the scored model. That was quick and painless, right? So you notice that training module has an exclamation point next to it, which means it needs something. So it wants us to pick the response class, and we identified a response class earlier and it was survived. And since we labeled it as a label, it won't have a problem accepting that. So just go ahead and run your model now. And that's all there is to us. And this is the strength of Azure ML. It can create models extremely fast. Most of your time is actually spent up here, remember, just formatting and processing your data. So let's visualize the evaluated model and see how well it did. It did okay. There's a huge gap up here. This is a chart that we want to be as high as possible. And you notice it doesn't have that good of a recall, but its accuracy seems pretty well. And its precision is also good as well. And what's really cool about this is because I have really bad recall, but it's fairly decent precision. I can give up some precision in order to get more recall just by sliding this bar around and lessening my threshold. And some of you sitting in your seats might actually wonder why I waited until the last possible second to cast my response variable into a label versus casting it up here when I did all the casting before. And I waited until the last possible second because what if I wanted to predict a different variable that wasn't survived? I could have just simply copied and pasted it and then started a new branch with a different label. And I would not have been able to do that if I had casted everything up here. Everything would have been changed. So I did all my pre-processing in a way that basically I can just export from this node going forward, and in the future, if I wanted to do anything else with all of my future variables, I could just save this as a data set. That way, the pre-processing doesn't have to happen again. And that concludes our video tutorial on how to create a model with an Azure ML. Join us next time where I will tackle this problem right here. And that is, this model is not that great. We can find better models. You will notice that the evaluate model has an extra node to compare another scored dataset against another dataset. So join us next time where I will show you how to run simultaneous models so that you can find a model of best fit.
If you like what you just saw, subscribe to our channel or leave us a comment. Let us know if there's a topic you want us to cover, and be sure to check us out at datasciencedojo.com. Until next time.